game one here. It's going to be, as we said before, Ubi versus House of 3000's very own Dilxper. And I have, oh wait, no, maybe I do know this guy. I think he actually goes to our weekly in Boston. If I'm correct, man, this Burn Ninja's a force. This is the reason this guy's still in Winners Top 48.
Yes,
I just saw him cleaning up House last week, I think.
And look at that, early 35%.
Up what house?
Just showing us how powerful he is, man.
House of 3000. House of 3000.
Cleaning that.
Oh my God, yes, here we go.
Tilts, bro. I just want all the tilts.
That down tilt's so good, man.
So good. It's such an oppressive tool, man.
Combos into itself. It can lead to that hard knockdown, too. I don't know what the like percent chance of it knocking down is. Probably some RNG obscure number.
And then, God forbid, you get stuck in shield. You get punished. Oh, you stuck. No, you're here now. You're here for the whole ride.
You trying to move? What do you do?
Nah. Jump? Okay, I got you covered.
And already we're seeing Dill come up to a pretty strong lead already percent-wise, has Ubi off stage trying to end him, and I love this setup.
Oh, he
there,
went for that charge. You see cheap stuff. That's what I'm saying.
Good mash, though. Good mash, though. He was able to get out of that. We're going to run it one more time, and he goes for the up air, knowing that, all right, he mashes pretty hard. Sometimes that's the mix-up, right? You mash very quick, and then it's like, exactly. So that time he's like, all right, I'm just going to go for the second read. Easy, nice enough. Dill going ahead, pulling up that lead.
Firing that giant laser is not going to make any mark, though. Ooh, makes it back. What a status.
And, oh, man. I mean, I got the notes right here. House of 3000 once again coming into the clutch. Devin telling me, so the one who put Kool-Aid in losers was actually Ubi himself. So there you have it. This man is here to play
today.
Taking out one of Massachusetts' finest. Not only that, taking out Dill as well at the same time as I say that. I mean,
look at that.
He's good. I mean, there's no doubt about that. He's good. Look at that. Clean conversion, 38, and he's racking up more.
60% immediately. That's so terrible.
And that's the thing, man. You're going to see Greninja jump a lot in the neutral game here. It's just kind of hard. That's why he gets so high so fast.
So fast.
Yeah.
And it's not like he's a fast follower, too. He's drifting.
Oh. All right, what we got for the edge guard here? Just going to set up. He misses the snipe there.
That was a nice little mix-up going to the platform up there to escape. Still gets caught out there, though.
Mm-hmm. Can't mix that up, though. Tries to dodge the up air. You will not be finding that success. But Dill's still setting up shop. You're 70%. And, you know, Rob is a pretty thick. Going to live for a little bit of some time here. Ooh, left.
Ooh.
Oh, no, not like this. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Hit him with the ooh wee.
Let him play. Let him play. Man.
Oh, man. Ubi's moving is very crisp. He just knows this character. Look at that.
Yeah, but where he's coming with the shortcomings, I guess, is he's having a hard time getting in, right? We were talking about how Greninja can get high pretty fast. He's going to come down with a descending aerial pretty often.
Ooh.
But you read it out just like that, you throw out a forward smash, it's not going to help you. And Dill going off what I consider a pretty convincing victory for that game one. Now, granted, we did say earlier before that everything in Top 48 is a best of five, so Ubi does still have some room to work with here to try and figure out the Dill matchup as well as the Rob matchup. And, of course, we do got Raffy.
What went wrong? Was it the stage? Do I need to switch? Maybe a character switch? He has a lot of things.
Now, I don't know if he plays anyone else. I don't think he does.
Not right now.
We'll see, but I don't think he plays anyone other than that Greninja.
I would run the back. I would do the run back on that. Maybe change stage, but the character didn't seem like it was the issue.
I agree. Especially a matchup like this, you know, Rob is a pretty fat character. I imagine he can probably get down tilt to up smash for a pretty large percent window. That'd just be my guess, considering how big the hurtbox is for Rob. So we can go ahead and take it to Pokemon Stadium 2. We're going to see if that's going to work out for him, man.
Got a little more breathing room, a little more running around. Ooh, and look, it's paying its dividends already.
Look at that money. He's racking up.
I know, right?
We want to gas him up, but it's like, all right, he's still finessing here. Dill working his way out the corner,
look
and he's
that.
Just holding shield.
His shield is done.
He didn't get poked, though. That's a great awareness, though. He was all right, said, you know what, I'll hold it for a little bit longer, keep forcing this offensive pressure from Dill, and then when I feel like I'm ready to go, that's when I'll decide to move. I won't force my way out.
Dill cleverly using the air dodge to pick up the item at the same time while making the defensive option. Really smart stuff for him. There's the little things that you notice that really pays how well you're doing as a character, you know, as a player.
And then we just saw right there from Ubi, there's a certain moment when Greninja manages to find that hit. He can kind of reset over and over. So he got that down to, he didn't go for an immediate follow-up like an up smash or anything. He's trying to get a reset. Oh, God, yeah, he just kind of emptied the tank.
Yo, you can't just counter in neutral. Yeah, we don't know.
That's like that car you see coming down the street that clearly needs to get checked out. Got the gray smoke coming up the back.
This is not looking good.
Man, Ubi's trying, but at this point, Dill's getting close to lapping him. You saw him go for that falling up air, get a few hits in there as well. Dill is looking good.
What are we going to see? What's the ledge here? Oh, that was a good read, but just barely missing on the side there. That force. Again with the neutral. Oh, no. What's coming out of this? Oh, okay. He's good.
Yeah, I like that. He goes for the immediate up tilt. Says, you know what? I'm going to get that guaranteed stuff set up for the juggle scenario. And just like that, he's able to find the KO by fishing for that up air.
Oh, is this grab? No, no grab. Greninja needs to find a kill soon.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my. Oh, he really went. Oh, he got the grab anyway. What is happening?
You need to be careful here. I'm sure at this point he's recognized that Ubi, after getting grabbed by that throw, has been opting to double jump immediately out of hit stun. And if he's able to read up on that, he'll be able to scout out the jump and get the KO next time.
Oh my God. That was a smart. He was going to try to go for a forward air, but got clipped by the beam anyway. Ooh, nice back.
Oh my God, wow. We're going to try to push him away a little bit with the Aqua Jet. Won't get much. Still looking for the KO. Can he at least get one stock? Dill.
Come on, Dill. You can do it, bro. We believe. There it is. All right. All right. We believed hard enough.
Ubi was able to find it, man, but it's not looking great.
Anything can happen. The set's not over yet.
Uh-oh.
Okay. All right. Well, he made it back. That's all that matters. Nice.
Timing mix-up. You can see he's trying to push Dill away with that Aqua Jet, but hasn't quite been able to line it up to force him in a terrible position. Has him off stage here, and Dill can take his time mixing up his way back to the stage as well. Has a lot of gas to work with.
Oh, nice up tilt. Gonna get a nice conversion off of that with the up air.
And he just hasn't been able to really find much more than that. You know, two-piece combo, not bad, but he's at 150% on his last stock. Dill, at this point, probably up throw even. No, just go for this one, up smash. Yeah, we'll take it.
Now, that was the second game. We have one more game, at least, at minimum.
Right, at least. But, I mean, the way this is looking, probably one more game.
Yeah, you know, looking a little rough. But he could have learned something. That's the important part.
He could have learned something. I hope so.
I hope so. But
here's the thing, though. You can never count people out. Now, granted, I have seen people get three stock and then win the next batch. Like, sometimes the adaptation can be that drastic. Now, granted, that was game one to game two. That was supposed to be the moment where he started to turn up a little bit. If you're going to turn up, you need to do it now. You're going to find yourself in the loser's bracket, and it's going to be a wealth time for you. You've got players like Matty G, as we mentioned before, who laid down. You're going to have to beat him again. You don't want to deal with that, so try to make your way through winners, play less, and earn more.
That's right. Maximize the reward. Okay, here we go. This 64 early percent lead looking really good so far. Let's hope we can keep that momentum. Oh, that was a perfect opportunity to strike. Kind of missed his point of entry, though.
Go. The thing that Ubi needs to look for here is every time he's able to land a landing neutral air onto the shield of Dill, he needs to take a mental note of what he's doing to get out here. But this ledge trapping and edge guarding we're seeing has been immaculate. Got 97%. That's a good amount. Can't confirm the KO, though, and now the tables have turned. Ubi!
Oh my gosh. Did he read the Shadow Snake? Oh my gosh. That was dangerous.
He just didn't get the sweet spot. That was guaranteed the stock had he gotten the sweet spot. You know, Ubi getting a second chance here. And nice conversion off of the neutral air, but still not enough to KO. Needs to find one more solid hit.
I really like the baits here. Going in and out. Ooh, the Hydro Pump. Not going to make its mark, though.
Okay, what are you going for here? Now, something that I feel like you could see from Ubi that he hasn't used quite yet is he can go for that down tilt and go for like a falling up air drag down and set up for the jab reset and try to go for a kill that way. Now, it looks like he's able to find his first kill with just a forward air neutral. This is the first time this set, I think, that he's been the first one to get the stock. We'll see how much he's able to collect before losing this one.
Actually, as we noticed, after doing some down tilts twice, our man Ubi decided to do a back roll. I wonder if he's gonna make an adjustment and leave the back roll next time he does some down tilts. He did it twice in a row already.
He could be scouting out that option, maybe saying, all right, I'm setting up the conditioning. If there's any time for me to do it now, maybe the next time I go for this, I'll be able to find the correct option to go ahead and collect some big damage. But man, Dill is playing off stage for a minute here. Oh my God, the Aqua Jet. I swear he was getting close to running out of gas.
The stage pressure is really good. Oh man, you can't get back to the stage at all. Yes.
Getting guarantee conversions. I like that. The cheap stuff.
Oh, man. He made it back. No, man.
I mean, yeah. I mean, Rob is thick, man. You got to at least eat one more of those.
But look how much damage he racked off all that edge guard. It was perfect. That's just what he needed.
I'm scared because we do have a good percentage lead on Ubi that is slowly dwindling. Here we go. The wave shine across the stage. That's what
travel.
I call that,
we
man.
Going for a walk. Come,
I mean, come on. We back, man. It's never gone. It's never gone.
And just like that, on the one stock, this is your tournament stock, man. Can you make it back?
Ubi still trying his best here. You know, he had a little bit of a lead. This could be guaranteed forward air. Connecting stat down to the reset. I love it.
It's all so dirty.
Oh my god, he's still pushing forward pretty much 60% unanswered from Dill.
Trying to get these hydro pumps to do something, but attacking through the stage, that's so perfect.
Mm-hmm. And that's the Rob special, man. You'll see him do it. You'll see Raffy X do it. Any Rob.
Ooh,
oh, deuces. Deuces, you're out.
It. That's it.
Man, Beyblade, let it rip. That's it. Dragoon.
Trigger.
Use your ultimate attack, man. You didn't stand a chance. I mean, that's the thing. There's so much base knockback on that forward special from Rob that if he goes for it in a moment like here, it's a wrap. It doesn't matter how much percent you have. You could have been at like 40. Probably still would have died.
He forced him to respect the gyro. That's how he got that. Mm-hmm. I don't want to get hit by this. I'm going to jump over it. Oh, yeah. I know
and that's
that.
The setup. That's the setup. We see Raffy do that every week.